Ephesians Chapter. My text will be there this morning. We got a new life in Christ. A new life in Christ. I mean, we got a new life in Christ. If it weren't for Christ, you wouldn't have the new life. My God sent His Son, His only begotten Son, to let His Son to die for us. We got a new life in Christ. It ain't nothing you done. Come back to nothing done. When you read this word with me, you know it won't nothing you done. It was a gift of who? God only begotten His Son. God being the only begotten Son. God being the only begotten Son. You know we are. We try to do the best we can, but my God is so awesome. So you got to believe in Him. Praise in God. Don't devil tell you one thing, and you're going to believe the door, or you're going to believe the whole truck. We're going to hold the time. That's all right. We're going to find it. He wants to stop this, but he ain't going to stop that. Yeah. It's in now. I know it's in me. So I got his mind. Yes, sir.
The second shadow.
Second shadow. Thank God I'm walking around today. Praise the Lord. He heard my cry, church. We got to walk by faith sometimes. Amen. I was walking by the fast when I was going to pick up the phone and call Pastor. But my spirit told me don't do it.
Amen.
When the spirit tells you to do something, you know it's the right spirit.
Amen.
He said, my sheep heard my voice. And I heard his voice right then. Thank you, God. Thank you, Jesus. Nobody don't know the pain I was in yesterday, but God knew. When you had it, said the word, amen.
Amen.
Say amen again.
Amen.
Tell God, thank you for this word this morning.
Thank you for the word.
Thank you for the word this morning. Thank you, God. Thank you, God. And it reads. He said, in you had he quickened who were dead in trespasses and sin. See, I can break it down a little bit before you can understand. Read it again. He said, in you had he quickened who were dead in sin. He said, we were spiritually dead, but because of our sin. We were spiritually dead because our sin. Then the thing we did against God. We were spiritually dead one time because the thing we did against God. We were spiritually dead. Verse 2, he said, where in time past you walk according to the course of this world. We were doing the same thing. I'm going to break it down to you. We were doing the same thing as the world was doing, but we got saved. We were doing the same thing as the world was doing. So we got to look at ourselves now. We were doing the same thing our brothers and sisters doing, our children doing now. We're doing the same thing they in the world, but my God. My God, it's up to my God gave us that new life.
Amen.
My God gave us that new life. You're going to see all this in a minute.
Amen.
God didn't. They want you. They want you. God did. He said, and we're going to, he said, according to the prince and the power of the earth, according to the according to the fallen of the evil rule or the evil power of the earth. That's what we fallen to, above the earth. We fallen to our evil spirit. Everything the world was doing, we were doing it one part of the time. That's what it was in the past. We were doing all this stuff. We were in the past. We were doing all that. Ain't nothing we ain't done. Come on, church, come by. We done did that, but we get up and we all holding and rolling. We ain't then did nothing. But my God knows what you done did. He got your name written. But you did good or bad, you got to be judged by what you done done. Somebody, I can't say you what I did. I can't tell you what you don't do. I ain't gonna get saved by what you don't do. I'm gonna get saved by what I don't do. I'm gonna be pretty bad or good. Whatever thing I don't do, but we all gonna do something in the past. Look what he said. That spirit work now. That spirit that now working those children of disobedience. He said, now, that same spirit working those who refuse to obey God. That same spirit now, disobedient, that they refuse to do what the Lord said to
them. It's working
up. That same spirit now. Come on, we think we all this now. I'm just preaching words to you this morning. How you got to do it? Get out of sin. We don't do something. Praise the Lord. We were disobeyed.
Amen.
We refused to do something God told us to do right now. You ought to tell God thank you.
Thank you, Lord.
Thank you, God. He said, among whom also we all have come to rest state in time past. We all were living as the world was doing. We don't deal as they were doing. As the world was doing. We're doing all the things the world was doing now. Mm-hmm. But we got saved with God.
Amen.
Ain't nothing no
different.
We were dead in what?
Yeah.
Our sin. We were dead in our sin. But God gave us a new life.
Right.
I still got to bring that new life in now. Mm-hmm. It won't hurt. Ain't nothing you did now. No, thank you. Ain't nothing what you doing. It's what God did. It's all things God did for us. And we put it on, we did.
Amen.
We got to get out of that. Come on, somebody. Somebody. He said, in the lust of the flesh, fulfill the desire of the flesh of man. He was telling us that now, we were trying to do everything that please our simple flesh.
That's right.
Our body. Mm-hmm. And our mind wants.
That's it.
That's what we were doing. We're trying to please that.
Amen.
That's what the elder flesh gonna come out. We try to do whatever our flesh wants us to do.
Amen.
You ought to tell God thank you. You ought to thank God for our new life today. I'm gonna break it down to you. I'm gonna break it down to you so you can understand. We was messed up people.
Amen.
We was messed up people.
Amen.
Come on, somebody. Can you understand what I'm talking about today? Come on now, church.
Amen.
I ain't gonna tell you nothing ain't in here. He said, whereby the nothing, the children of the wrath. He was saying that we should have suffered God's anger. Because of the way we were doing. We could have sucked his anger because of the way he was doing.
Right.
We could have sucked his anger the way we were. But that new life, I'm going to keep on saying that new life with Christ. That new life
saved
us. And what he said, and look what he said. Even as a we just like the other people. We still did everything the other people do. Somebody ought to say thank you, God.
Amen.
You ought to see where I'm coming from today.
Yes.
Come on, somebody. I ain't bringing nothing bad to you this morning.
Amen.
We don't deal this stuff.
Amen.
This is the word. We think we all out of mind. But we don't deal.
Like
come on, somebody. Ain't that good? Ain't that so good? You can smile on it. I can tell the author. Believe the verse 4. But God, who is rich in mercy, for his great love, wherewith will he love us? He said, God's mercy is great through love of the world. That's all the truth right there. God, great mercy, because he loves us that much. He didn't say no, he didn't say you. He said, God, mercy, come on somebody. Y'all ain't get with me right now. Come on somebody. It's God's mercy.
Right.
It's great. Mm-hmm. And he loves us that much.
Right.
Come on, even though we were not
fit.
Come on somebody. He loves us that much, church. Come on somebody. He said, even when we were dead in our sin, even when we're dead, when we did all the things against God,
mm-hmm.
when we spirit dead and did the things we didn't go,
mm-hmm.
he gave us what? New life.
Mm-hmm.
He gave us not new life and put us back together with Christ. By grace,
mm-hmm.
you are what?
Saved.
By what?
Grace.
Grace, you are saved. It won't you. It won't you. It won't you. He said, when we were dead in our sin, even when we were dead in our sin, he had quickened together with Christ by grace, you are saved. When we were spirit dead, did all we did against God. But God gave us that new life. Put us back together with Christ. In Christ. By grace, you are saved.
Mm-hmm.
By who? He said God, did it? He said God put us back together. Come on, somebody. By grace of God. I ain't going to be here in a long time with you today, church. I'm just going to get some facts right. It won't never we don't done. And won't never we had done, but we ain't done. We done did everything somebody else had done, might be in a little different way, a little fashion way, but we done did it, church.
All has
sinned and come to short of God. You ought to tell God thank you this morning.
Thank you, Lord.
Once I was blind, but now I see. Come on, somebody. I see your light right now.
Yeah.
I know who to call on now.
Yeah.
I know when I was going through yesterday. I know who to call on, somebody. The doctor didn't heal my back this morning. The Lord healed my back. I know when he did it last night, about 1 o'clock, I woke up. I didn't have no pain in my back. And I said, Lord, thank you. I can get out here. I can go to preaching, your people this morning.
Yeah.
I said, Lord, thank you. I went on to talk about this morning. I said, Lord, thank you. Thank you, God, because I couldn't get over last night. But this morning, it's a new day, and I can tell my God, I know who you are. I know how high you is. Come on, somebody. Nobody can do you like you. You ought to give God some praise this morning. You don't know Jesus, better get to know him like I do. If the doctor didn't do it, come on, somebody. The doctor didn't do it this morning to me. I didn't think I was going to be ready to preach to God this morning.
You
thank you, God. I didn't think I'm going to be ready to do it this morning, church. Praise the Lord. But I called on the Savior this morning.
Yeah.
And I listened to the song and said, you don't trust me, you might well walk away. I trust you this morning, Lord, for all my feelings. For I know who you are. You ain't had a call from the doctor's ready to see you all the time. As that pastor said, you gotta have a personal relationship. Gotta have a relationship with Jesus. Did he say that in the morning? This morning, the Sunday school, relationship. I know who that relationship is now, church. He opened my eyes.
Thank you, Lord.
He opened my eyes last night. I can walk. I can talk.
You can take the
But I can taste it. I can taste and see. I can taste and see. Come on, somebody. I can see. Come on, somebody. Thank God it's good. Come on, somebody. Amen. Thank you, God. Oh, verse 6. And he had written it up together and made up, set together in heaven place in Christ Jesus. He said, now I rich you up, and I gave you a seat with him in heaven. Come on, somebody.
In Christ Jesus.
Come on, somebody. That's all that is. Come on, somebody. Do you see how he broke it down to you? Can you see all he had did for you? Now, it won't nothing you did. Come on, somebody. He said, God did all this.
Amen.
Don't forget God did all this. Mm-hmm. It won't do, but God did all this.
Yes.
That's what I'm trying to let you see. Take yourself off the way when somebody doing wrong. But if you read it, they said we all had this. Come on, somebody. Somebody heard my weak voice this moment. I hope you heard my weak voice this moment. Because God, the word said we all had this. We did it like the world did. We're a part of the evil power above the earth. That's all this evil stuff going on there. We're doing the nasty stuff. We're doing all this stuff. God, as the world was doing it. Thank you. Can you see how God will come in and change you?
Yeah.
We got a new life with God now. We ain't got to have to go back and have it. God, we got to repent for it. Can you get me now? God, we got to do repent.
Hallelujah.
On account of God. Come on, somebody. Thank God it's good. Thank God it's good.
Yes, he is.
Can I go to look for? Come on. Ain't it getting right hot to you this morning? Can you feel the spirit going in you right now?
Yes.
You see what God did for you right now?
Yes.
Come on, somebody. God ain't slow in nothing he do. Come on, somebody. Because reading here, I know he on time. Because you asked my part this morning.
Amen.
I know he on time, God. You can't tell me nothing God can't do.
Amen.
He did it for me this morning. I got a new day. Come on, I can shout and praise in this morning. Because he gave me the strength this morning.
Yeah.
When I thought I didn't have strength this morning. He gave me the strength to see a new day.
Lord.
A new day I just thought to do it this morning. But now I know Jesus. Come on, somebody. I want to have everyone's ahead. Put that in there too. What God gave me.
Yeah.
He do the same for you. Now we got to call on his name. All we got to call his name. He ain't no separate call or somebody. He do it for you, he do it for me. I'm just going to definitely break it down to you right this morning. I know you might not understand, but go back home and read it for yourself. But I know what God did for me, he do it for you. He did that back in for the people. Did all this, he do it for you.
Amen.
He do it for you, church. He do it for you. Just think about it. Let's go website. I ain't got one with you. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. He said in that, then in the age and time to come,
mm-hmm.
He might show the essence of his riches. He said now in that, he was talking about the age time. He's talking about the future time. Can you get me? Can you keep what I'm saying? He was talking about the time now, the future time. Back in our day, he said the age is too current. That means the future, right? That's what you're talking about. He's talking about the future.
Yes, ma'am.
He's talking about by his didn't go over there again. But his according to his risen grace. By Jesus Christ.
Yes, ma'am.
By Jesus Christ. His grace, by his kindness, told us in Jesus Christ.
Amen.
They put us back together again by his kindness.
That's right.
In Jesus Christ.
Right.
Ain't nothing wrong with Jesus.
Nothing wrong with
Jesus. Ain't nothing wrong with Jesus. Yes. All this he did for you.
Amen.
All the things he did, he told you to believe. And if he did it, he It shows you what he did for us, but you can't see it. His kindness and his grace put us back together with Christ. You see that?
Amen.
God did it. That's what makes it so easy to buy. Okay, he said, by grace, you are saved through faith. And in debt, not of yourself. Mm-hmm. This is the good of God. It says it's the gift. Mm-hmm. By God's grace. Ain't nothing we did. I'm just going to try to get it with my feet. I ain't going to preach about the word stuff. So. I could be preaching about the gospel. What Christ is. Mm-hmm. I can't preach to you about first grade and second grade. I ain't coming to preach about college and all this other stuff. I'm coming to preach you about the word of God. That's what God told me to do. He told me to leave that other stuff out there to the world. And you preach what I tell you. That's what I'm trying to do right now.
Amen.
I don't care what you did in the first grade, the second grade, on up to the 12th grade, on up to the college year.
Amen.
But I'm going to preach you what God told me to preach to you.
Amen.
I'm going to preach to the gospel to you. Thank God. That's all God told all them pastors to preach the gospel. And that's how you go down and preach about everything. You let the school teacher have it, first and second grade, you let the college, the profession have it, the rest of it. And you let the preacher get the word out.
Amen.
That's what I'm talking about. Get the word out. And let the people understand the word. That's all you got to do.
Amen.
That's all is that in the future. Thank the age to come. Can you see it now? But his, come on somebody.
Okay.
He said, the age to come is his grace and his kindness. By Jesus Christ.
Mm-hmm.
We are saved by Jesus Christ. Just as the Lord thank you. He said, not on your work.
Mm-hmm.
Let any man should boast. He said, let any man. Now I'm going to read that again. I want y'all to get that plain. Not on your word. Let any man should boast. He was telling you, he said, so it won't, back it up here, it wasn't your restored of your effort. It won't what you restored your effort. It won't you do it. Because you can't brag about it. Come on, somebody. See what I'm saying? You can't brag about it. Then he comes through that all right. You can't preach that. You can't beat that what God gave you.
Amen.
Come on, somebody. It won't nothing to it. It won't nothing to your restoring your effort.
Amen.
You can't brag about it. Here. Yeah. I used to be this word in my life, I heard in the past, but he gave it to me.
Yeah.
Come on, somebody.
That's
good. It won't nothing you did now. You didn't store nothing. Your effort didn't do it. Ain't nothing you did. Ain't nothing your mom and daddy did.
That's right.
Ain't nothing your father did. Ain't that the preacher did? Come on, somebody. Ain't that an amen? Can I get an amen? That won't matter. Nobody did with me.
Amen.
You can't. How can you brag about it?
Amen.
Huh?
Amen.
Can't brag about it again. Well, who can't brag about ourselves, huh? That's how I was trying to get you right there. Just the last one we're winding up. Oh, praise God. I ain't gonna give you too much today. For we are his workmanship, created in Christ Jesus, and through good works which God has before ordained that we should walk in them. I'm gonna break it down to the best. I'm gonna break it down to good to be supposed to understand. We are what God made us to be today. get out of your head. It was God who Jesus Christ did. It won't nothing. It won't our work. It was through and by Jesus Christ did it for us in Jesus' name. He said, God made us to do good works. He made us do work, good work, because He had planned it for us. Even before He had planned it for us.
Amen.
See, I'm just giving you a little bit of it right now. He had a plan to do this to build our life. Lord, come on, somebody. That's all it is. We got it. He said He planned it for us. Amen. Live our life doing it.
Amen.
Amen. It's your receiver today.
Amen.
Thank you, God.
Amen.
Thank you, Lord. Thank you, God. I'm turning back 100 to the pulpit.